Welcome! What operators are winners and losers with the introduction of Finka and Lion? And how will the big nerf on Ela affect the game? Find out if your main operator is a winner or loser on this big Rainbow Six Siege update. First, I will go through the new operators and the operators' buffs and nerfs to see what operators are winners and losers in those cases. After that, in the end of the video, I will rank the three biggest winners and losers in this patch. If we start with introduction of Finka. As you all know, Finka can enhance the ability of everybody in her team with her adrenaline surge. Everybody in her team will get extra HP that can also revive teammates that are downed, and the team gets less recoil, can move faster through barbed wire, and they're also less affected by concussion and flashbang symptoms. So, first off, how do you counter Finka? She has four straight counters that defenders can use against her ability. First off, the faster breathing after her adrenaline surge will make attackers take more damage from smoke's toxic gas canisters, and their higher heart rate will make them visible from longer distances for pulse. Then you also have two softer counters towards the Finka boost, and that's Lesion and Echo. If you run into a Lesion mine or get stunned by Echo's drone, you will lose your adrenaline surge. So, if you look at winners and losers with the introduction of Finka, we can see that Smoke, Pulse, Lesion, Echo are big winners since they can counter her and will be even more useful for defenders now. Other possible winners here are Frost and Capcan, as attackers might use her ability to rush the objective in a much higher pace, and then the traps can come in handy if the attackers are not careful. Losers are basically all defenders, since the recoil for the attackers after Finka boost is almost none, and it's very hard to win that engagement. But the biggest loser is Ela, due to the fact that her mines will have a less effect on the attackers than before, and she also carries barbed wire that they now can sprint through quicker. That also means that all defenders that carry barbed wire is somewhat of a loser in this update, since the Finka boost will be used a lot, especially this season, I think. If you move on to Lion then, he has a drone that you can't destroy that give your team 3 scans, then if a defender moves their feet during the scan, they will be visible for your entire team so you can shoot them through walls, ceilings and floors. After I have been playing quite a lot with him on the TTS servers before the release of him, the impression is somewhat mixed. If you don't use him smart, he is mostly useless. Since the defenders will get a warning that the scan is incoming, they can easily stand still, hold their angle. But if you're using him in a situation where you do a final push, or even better, after the bomb has been planted, it's much more effective. But I think we'll have to wait and see when people start to use him, start to adapt to playstyle, make new strats, and also make counter strats to him to really see how effective Lion can be. But what operators are winners and losers after the introduction of Lion? Mute is an obvious winner, since he can block the scan from all teammates that are standing close to a mute jammer. On the attacking side, I think we also can bring in Fuse as a winner, since if you time it right with the Lion scan, Fuse can make all defenders on the objective move to avoid his Fuse charge, and then when getting tagged, you can have teammates ready to shoot them through walls, ceilings and floors. Losers then? I don't think any specific operator is more or less a loser with Lion. It all depends on how the attackers are using him. If they're using him during the final push, then defenders like Rook, Doc, Smoke, Mira that often anchor on the site are losers. But if they use it after the plant have gone down, then the roamers like Ela, Bandit and Jagger trying to get back to the objective are the biggest losers. What about the big nerf to Ela then? They have added to her recoil, so it's much harder to control, and they also dropped her damage from 28 to 23 on close range and from 18 to 15 on distances over 28 meters. On top of this, Ela has also lost her impact grenades, and with the introduction of Finka, all attackers are less affected by her mines and can also run pretty quick through her barbed wire. Adding all this together, this is one of the biggest nerfs to an operator, says Blackbeard, especially if you add in the earlier nerfs that they have done to her. But this is of course necessary, since she's been way too good. I still think that she will be a good pick, but you have to adapt how you play with her, trying to get more close quarters engagement with attackers, since her huge fire rate, you can still tear people apart at close range, even with the new recoil and damage drop. And I think all attackers are happy to both see less of Ela and when facing her, knowing that her recoil and damage have been nerfed to make their lives easier. Blitz, on the other hand, he will get a big boost after his buff. In the patch notes, they listed him that he would be a 2-speed operator. And when I was playing Blitz as a 2-speed operator with the ability to sprint with the shield and the Finka boost activated, way too overpowered. Ubisoft saw this very quickly and have now changed him to be a bit faster than before, but not a full 2-speed operator. But still, with the introduction of Finka with her boost, Blitz is now a much more viable player, and a good Blitz player can without a doubt wreak havoc with the new faster Blitz and the Finka boost. This will make Blitz a big win in this patch, but also operators like Capcan, Frost and Lesion, since rushing Blitz often misses traps when charging in on the objective full speed. The biggest losers on this Blitz update I think will be the anchors that are standing on the side, and most of the time we will find our usual suspects here that will have to deal with the charging Blitz. Roamers don't really have to deal with him that much because they can pretty easily escape and get away and try to get a new engagement from another angle if they get caught up by Blitz. So if we summarize all the updates, all the new operators, what are the biggest losers and biggest winners? If we start with losers. By far, the biggest loser without a doubt is Ela. She has been nerfed from she was released, but I think this is the time when they really got her right. With these updates, she will still be a good operator, but not a must pick that just dominate the attackers. Then, shared second place of biggest loser, Jaeger and Bandit. They are very high picks on the defensive team, and they both carry barbed wire that they often use, and with the Finka boost, this barbed wire will be much less effective. Sure, we have other operators that also can carry barbed wire, but they are either not as much picked as Jaeger and Bandit, or often use other gadgets than their barbed wire. Like for example, you will never see a pulse run barbed wire because he needs a C4 and so on. When it comes to winners, we have more operators fighting about the title of biggest winner. Let's start with the third position where we have Smoke. Sure, he also uses the barbed wire that is less effective now, but I think a lot of teams will run with Finka this season, and when she uses her Adrenaline Surge to boost her teammate, the toxic gas from Smoke's canister are much more powerful against teams with the boost activated. On top of that, he also has his shotgun as a primary weapon that will be even more useful now when Ela has lost her impact grenades. If we move on to the second spot, we find Lesion. He is getting really handy now. Attackers stepping on his goo mines will lose their Finka boost, and with attackers coming in at higher speeds than before when rushing the objective, they will most likely have less time to see the mines and step right into them. The mines are also very useful against Blitz, who see even less with his big shield up when rushing the objective. Who is the biggest winner then in this patch? No other than our man Blitz. After community outcry of buff Blitz, he got a first buff when he was able to sprint with his shield up, but now with this buff, even if they reduced his speed from the first patch note to when he's going live, he's still a big winner here. I will not say that he is overpowered after they slowed him down, but in the right hands, this new Blitz with combination of the Finka boost would be a terrifying enemy for all defenders in this game. That's it for this time. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like since it's really helping me out. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time. We'll be right back.